My name is Hans van der Schroef. I'm from the Netherlands. My first touch with the Formula One is actually back to 1980s, when the duel between Ayrton Senna and Alain Prost was in full glory. One of my friends was a very big fan of Alain Prost. And actually watching with him to the Formula One, I thought Ayrton was the cooler guy. So I was more attracted to Ayrton Senna. I remember the days after his death, I really started to go more deep in where he stood for. So before that, it was more the Formula One, the duel. After his death, I came more related to his values and the person he was. We started with a documentary. This was 10 years after his death. Also to show the other side of him, who was only known a long time after his death, because people still feel very, very connected to him as a person. And of course also he was a winner, that's true. But on the other side, he also stood for good. And the good he stood for is so much needed. I think the reason why people still shout for him is the call for good. I think that's what they need. Not corruption, but the other side. And I think he stands for the other side. Ayrton is an icon. He's far bigger than Formula One. Like Marilyn Monroe was bigger than just an actress. He needs a portrait like Andy Warhol created for Marilyn, just with his expression, who he was. So I think the original idea of the portrait was started then. The selection of the picture also took quite a while because there are so many. There are hundreds of thousands of beautiful pictures, but most of them are very much Formula One. And we really needed one who not only express the strong guy he was, but also the sensitive side and the feelings and all his appeal to other people should be in the picture. And the Institute, the family, the artist Ian Berry and myself, we all decided, yeah, but this is the one we need. So the portrait is not only with regular jeans, but most of them are made of jeans of his family. That was a very special extra dimension to have in the portrait. We were invited to unveil the portrait to the Institute and to the family, who were very much involved, but they never saw the final portrait. And suddenly the phone rang and it was Ayrton's mother who asked to see the portrait. She came in the room and she walked to the portrait. And from then on, it was beautiful to experience that she was, for a very long time, really only very strongly looking to the portrait. She actually gave the blessing to the whole project, being so touched by the result and saying that every little detail in his face was correct. During the conversation we had after seeing the portrait, she really was very strong in, yeah, but this shouldn't be in my room hanging only for me, but this should be seen around to his fans, to people around the world. So we did. The reactions on the original portrait are actually unbelievable everywhere you go. It doesn't matter what kind of country. It's not that it's only in Brazil so emotional. It's taking the emotions of people after such a long time, as if the accident just happened, or they were thinking of him. You asked what is the bigger goal, and a beautiful result would be if people, by seeing the portrait, would be inspired by Ayrton and his values. Yeah.